Hello and welcome to ISTV English News, and let's have the top stories in the news today. After passing three bills, JCILPS to hold talks with state government. And now the news in detail. After the three most awaited bills were passed unanimously in Manipur Legislative Assembly yesterday, the Joint Committee on Inner Land Permit System is going to hold talks with the state government today. The Joint Committee is likely to bring up certain points that have not been included in the bills and ask the government to translate them into action. On the other hand, performing last rites of Sapam Robin Hood, release of volunteers from detention, and extending financial help to those who sustained injuries during the agitations are likely to come up during the talks. On the other hand, a meeting of the Council of Ministers chaired by the Chief Minister was held yesterday. Later, Education Minister M. Okendro, who is also the spokesperson of the government, said that the bills passed by the State Assembly won't affect the interests of the tribal people living in the state and cause any disadvantage to any community at all. The bills are to protect the indigenous people and also not to facilitate easy purchase of land of the state by any outsider. Therefore, no community should have any wrong notions of the bills, the minister said, and appealed to all concerned to stop agitations. On the other hand, the state government has taken up security measures to control the trouble that erupted at Churachandpur, Kangpokpi and Saitu Assembly constituencies, it is learned. The 9th chapter night celebration of Lions Club of Imphal Lamerol was held at the multipurpose hall of City Hospital at Chingmerong yesterday. Social Welfare Minister A.K. Mirabai, MLA Landhoni, MLA Y. Surchandra, President of Lamerol KSH Madhavi and Chairperson Bilasini attended the celebration as the main guests. With the objective of keeping the Wangoi Community Health Center neat and clean, Vice President of MPCC S. Achoba and staffs of the Community Health Center have cleaned the CHC. The CHC has conveyed sincere thanks to all those who helped cleaning the center. Following the passage of three bills in the Manipur Legislative Assembly yesterday after more than 2 months of unprecedented mass movement that witnessed death of a student and injuries to several hundreds of people, several student organizations based in the hills have been launching agitations in protests against the bills since yesterday. Meanwhile, it is learned that Kuki Students Organization KSO Chandel District Branch has called indefinite ban from 12 noon today at Moray border town. Now let's take a short break.
I'm ready.
Telero.
Editor ka late.
Some say uzik pati perfectly straight ado kankar kanda di freezy.
Relax. Perfectly straight.
Aina say me ano ba sansil perfectly straight with straight lock technology maramdi. Some kankar ba matung dasu align straight oina laina bagidama.
Wow. Hujik su straight oirina.
Straight and gorgeous. Sunsilk Perfect Straight, Lock W, Rock W.
Brozen, president of Thamaiban United Club, which is also an apex body of 29 clubs, has told the media persons that it is a common desire of the residents of Thamaiban areas that the memorial site of late Sapam Robin Hood may be set up atop Chairau Ching. He said this at the Thamaiban waiting shed, where fast unto death protest was held. He also thanked the government for passing the three bills, fully knowing the desire of the people of the state. Further, he urged the JC formed against the killing of Robin Hood and JCILPS to give consent to the proposal of constructing the memorial site at Chairau Ching.
Masista Rong Chabdu Legada Boyagadi Kwegi Tamil Prajana Sumadu Yamna Nungai Jagani Habigi Wapamsi Amjaraga Sadi.
And now the national and international news. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will address his fourth and last Parivartan rally in Bagalpur in eastern Bihar on Tuesday. Modi's public engagement coming just 48 hours after the Swabhiman rally organized jointly by the Janata Parivar and Congress at Patna's Gandhi Maidan will be used by the Bharatiya Janata Party led National Democratic Alliance to target Board Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar and Rashtriya Janata Dal Supremo Lalu Prasad. While NDA is yet to finalize the seat sharing, but its leaders have feigned across the state to lure Bihar voters by highlighting the 1.65 lakh crore rupees package announced by Modi at a rally in Arar on August 18, which was countered by Nitish Kumar's promise of investing 2.7 lakh crore rupees in various schemes. Modi has already addressed rallies in Gaya, Muzaffarpur, Arar and Saharasa in the run-up to the assembly elections in Bihar, which are scheduled to take place in October and November. The term of the current assembly ends on November 29. In Odisha, a hardcore Maoist who carried 1 lakh rupee award on his head and was allegedly involved in many crimes surrendered before the police in Malkangiri district. Superintendent of Police Mitra Bhanu Mohapatra said Maoist Mesa Musaki and 126 of his sympathizers belonging to Silakota village surrendered before the Malkangiri district collector and superintendent of police. Armed cadres of CPI Maoists, on whose head government of Odisha has declared 1 lakh reward, has surrendered with us yesterday. His name is Mesa Musaki. He was active in Bodiala. Along with him, 126 members of Jan militia of village Lakota have surrendered with us to join the mainstream. And we welcome them to the mainstream of the society, he said. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has said that the government will safeguard the interests of soldiers retiring at an early age through higher pensions. He, however, said it is not possible to revise pensions every year as demanded by the hesitating ex-defense personnel. Jaitley told a private channel that the government is committed to one rank, one pension ORP, but the only difficulty is the arithmetical translation. I have my own formula on what ORP means. Somebody else may have his own formula on what ORP means, but it has to be within reasonable and rational criteria. You can't have an ORP where pensions are revised every month or every year. It doesn't happen anywhere in the world. And I'm sure armed forces, which are very, very patriotic, very, very professional, including the veterans, we accept the principle. We will implement the principle. ORP emphasizes a uniform pension for defense personnel who retire in the same rank with the same length of service, irrespective of the date of retirement. A satellite image confirms that the main temple in the ancient city of Palmyra in northern Syria has been destroyed, the United Nations says. There had been earlier reports of an explosion at the Temple of Bel in Palmyra, which is held by militants from the Islamic State group. Syria's antiquities chief had earlier said the basic structure of the 2,000-year-old site was intact. But UN satellite analyst Yunuset say the image shows almost nothing remains. Unfortunately, the images we acquired do show that the main building of the temple has been destroyed, Inar Jorgo, UNASOT's manager, said. Before we close the top stories once again. After passing three bills, JCILPS to hold talks with state government. That's all for now and keep watching ISTV News Update.